Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Disciples of Tamal Krishna Goswami that not many people know, because they don't often come to the Holy Dham, but these are very, very early disciples. And I am very happy and honored to see that we have one here today who was one of the very, very first disciples of Tamal Krishna Goswami in America in 78. And this is Radha Gopinath Prabhu. So we'll ask him to come and speak. He has lots of memories to share.
Omagyana tamaranda syagina gina shilakaya chakshur unmilitam yena tasmai shri gurave nama mukum karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim yat kripa tamaham vande shri gurum dinatarnam. Thank you, Radha Charan. Being there first isn't always the biggest qualification. I wanted to first of all thank all the wonderful devotees, God brothers of Tamal Krishnamaraj, my uncles and aunts, my God brothers, God sisters, nieces and nephews that have come to honor Srila Tamal Krishna Maharaj, as we, as disciples, affectionately call him Srila Gurudev. When I first met Tamal Krishna Maharaj in 1978, his name was Goswami Maharaj. It wasn't Maharaj. It wasn't Goswami. It was Goswami Maharaj. It was the spiritual equivalent of a four-star general. And he was very hard to get close to in those days for a new devotee. He had so much responsibility. Srila Prabhupada had just finished one chapter of this world. And he had come back to America, first to St. Louis, the home of Sri Sri Nitai Gaur Nataraj, beautiful deities, dancing deities of Lord Nityananda and Lord Chaitanya. And I was thinking about this the last couple days, that all my, at that time, the temple in St. Louis was the hub of the Radha Damodar party. We still had three buses, and it was book distribution on maximum. And there was very few people who did not go out on Sankirtan full time. There was the BBT library party, there was airport parties, everything was book distribution. Everyone was eating and sleeping book distribution. And when Tamal Krishna Maharaj came to St. Louis, we began to eat, drink, and lick everything we could, book distribution. And because it was hard to get close to him, for aspiring disciples, we immediately went out on Sankirtan. But before we went out on Sankirtan, the next day after Tamal Krishna Maharaj arrived, was Radhastami. And many of you have heard the story of Tamal Krishna Maharaj finding his Radha Gopinath deities in Juhu Beach, or finding Gopinath in Juhu Beach. And when he came to America, he had brought a beautiful Radharani that had been given to him by, I don't know the details on that. I'm sure it's there in some history. But so it was Radhastami. So we installed Srimati Radharani with his Gopinath deity that he had found in Juhu Beach. And we also, it was a new temple in St. Louis. We had just moved the deities to a new temple. And after installing Srimati Radharani and installing a beautiful new murti of Srila Prabhupada, we had initiations. And so there was an initiation. And there was five devotees given first initiation and seven given second initiation. So that's when I got initiation. That was extremely wonderful. Guru Krishna Prasade by Bhakti Lata Bij. So I didn't have any qualification. I didn't know my spiritual master other than by the words of my wonderful uncles, and just worshiping his picture and going out and worshiping him by serving, doing sankirtan every day. That was St. Louis. Very shortly after that, because Tamal Krishna Maharaj wanted to really drum up sankirtan and drum up book distribution in the United States again and get things really rolling again, he purchased a mobile home, a travel home. And it just so happened that this travel home was called a Barth. So we called it the Maha Barth. And Tamal Krishna Maharaj, with several devotees, would travel around from temple to temple, inspiring people and making devotees. Very shortly after that, he received the Houston, Dallas, and Chicago temples and the zones. And so he had quite an area of traveling to do. And so this was a great facility for him. I'll tell one other small story, because you can read Servant of the Servant and Diary of TKG, but all the memories that each of you will share today, these are very special because they're personal. So there was one very wonderful time. We had been on Sankirtan in Nebraska. It's in the north central United States, for those of you who don't know geography of the area. But we had we would go out for 2 weeks or 3 weeks in our vans, distribute books, and then come and meet together. And every once in a while, Srila Gurudev loved to give special attention to his Sankirtan devotees. So he came to this state park in his Mahabharat, and we had wonderful, intimate connection programs for several days. And there was one time where there was a river running through this state park. And northeast corner of Missouri. I think it was Lewis and Clark State Park. And we all went swimming. So it was during the summer. And Srila Gurudev got in the water and just spontaneously he said, let's have a kirtan. So he got in the center and we got circumambulated him. And we got in the water around him. Everyone took a station. There was about 12 Sankirtan devotees there. And he said, so now just tap the water like the kartals. And we began to start chanting. And it was just real soft and real sweet. And that tune that, who was it that was leading the kirtan last night? No, after that, I think. Radha Swami was leading that Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So that was the melody, and we were just tapping, and it was very nice. And so anyways, I Can't wait to hear all your wonderful stories. Thank you very much. Srila Gurudev Ki.